Friends, welcome back to Gora Tutorials. This is the fifth video in the lecture series of photosynthesis. I hope you would have seen the other videos. If not, then the link is provided in the description box. Please check them out. They would be really very helpful. In this particular video, we would talk about photophosphorylation, a very important part of light reaction other than photolysis of water. As per Arnon, it is not that during the light reaction, only the NADP is reduced to NADPH2, but also there is the formation of ATP or synthesis of ATP, which is directly related to the presence of light. And since light plays a role in the process of formation of ATP, it is called as photophosphorylation. If you split down the word, you get photo, which means light, and phosphorylation, which means addition of phosphate group. If the phosphate group is added to ADP, it forms ATP. If a layman were to describe the process of photophosphorylation, it could be formation of ATP from inorganic phosphate and ADP in presence of sunlight. The reaction can be summed up as ADP plus inorganic phosphate in presence of light yield ATP. Photophosphorylation are of two types, cyclic and non-cyclic. We would discuss both of these, but first we would talk about cyclic photophosphorylation. The process of cyclic photophosphorylation is observed in those plants where NADP is either scarce or if at all it's not available. During this, we could find that ADP along with the inorganic phosphate in presence of light and in chlorophyll A would observe the cyclic transfer of electron to generate ATP. This type of event is found predominantly in case of bacteria. Since there is a cyclic flow of electron, the process is called as cyclic photophosphorylation with participation of only photosystem 1, with reaction center being P700. During this event, ATP is synthesized in two stages, where the electron passes from the electron transport system. The electron transport system is a complex of proteins which are arranged in the decreasing order of their redox potential. They are ferredoxine, plastoquinone, cytochrome B complex, and finally plastocyanin. If one is to observe the cyclic photophosphorylation diagrammatically, it could be assumed that there is a photosystem 1 with a lot of antenna complex and a reaction center, which is P700. We do know that the PS1, which is photosystem 1, would have its reaction center as P700, and P700 would absorb a light of 700 nanometer. Whenever light of 700 nanometer would fall on this reaction center, it would cause the electron in the chlorophyll of P700 to excite and thus get released. This released electron from the P700 would be accepted by primary electron acceptor and would pass on its energy subsequently to other complex molecules like ferredoxine, plastoquinone, cytochrome, and plastocyanin. The electrons from acceptor are passed to ferredoxine and then to plastoquinone. During this, the ADP is converted into ATP, which is the first step of release of ATP. The electrons from plastoquinone are passed to the cytochrome complex, and from cytochrome complex, they would go to plastocyanin. Again, ADP would be converted into ATP, the second step of ATP release. The electron from the plastocyanin would then go back to its sink, which is P700. So what we observed was that light fell on the reaction center. It causes the excitation of the electron, which is accepted by the electron acceptor. It passes the electron to the electron transport system, whereby 2 ATP are generated and this electron come back to its origin. Now, since the electron travels back to its origin and creates the phosphorylation of ADP, the process is called as cyclic photophosphorylation. Now, we would talk about non-cyclic photophosphorylation, and as the name suggests, non-cyclic, the electron won't return back to its sink, back to its origin. Here, ADP along with the inorganic phosphate in presence of light and chlorophyll A would see the non-cyclic transfer of electron to generate ADP. This type of event is more dominant in case of green plant, and this would involve both photosystem 1 and photosystem 2, with their reaction system being P700 and P680 respectively. Non-cyclic flow of electron would occur, and hence the name is non-cyclic photophosphorylation. Here, we would find both ATP and NADPH2 are synthesized. The ATP would be synthesized only once during this reaction. diagrammatically we would find that there is photosystem 2 which is present first and it is followed by PS1 later on. The PS2 has its reaction center as P680, and whenever a light of 680 nanometer would fall on it, it would cause the electrons in the molecule of P680 to get excited and thus get released. This released electron from the P680 would be accepted by primary electron acceptor. This primary electron acceptor, having the electron with more energy, is passing this electron to a molecule called as pheophytin. From the pheophytin, the electron would be moved into plastoquinone. From the plastoquinone, the electron would be moved into cytochrome B6F complex, and then from the B6F complex, it would be passed to plastocyanin. Every time the electron is passed from plastoquinone to cytochrome B6F complex, it produces ATP from ADP. These four molecules, that is pheophytin, plastoquinone, cytochrome B6F complex and plastocyanin, are referred to as electron transport system. In both the cases, for cyclic and non-cyclic, the electron transport system would have different components. The electron from the plastocyanin would pass into the P700, which is the reaction center of PS1. And when the light of this 700 nanometer would fall onto P700, it would cause the excitation of the electron in the chlorophyll of P700. And thereby this electron would be released, and this released electron would be again accepted by the primary electron acceptor. This acceptor would pass on the electron to iron sulfur complex. The electrons from the iron sulfur complex would be passed on to ferredoxin. The electrons from the ferredoxin would be then passed on to NADP reductase. Now, as the name suggests, the NADP reductase would use these electrons and reduce the NADP into NADPH2. Now, friends, I do have with me ATP and NADPH2, which I would use in the dark phase of photosynthesis. This non-cyclic photophosphorylation is affected by or inhibited by DCMU, which is a herbicide. What it would do is, it would be a strong inhibitor of photosystem 2. Kids, you can pause the video and write down the differences between this cyclic and non-cyclic photophosphorylation. So that is it, guys. I hope you would have understood the video. Do like the video, share the video, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much. May God bless you all.